Hi, I'm Ali Blazowski, the Alamo Area MPO's Regional Transportation Planner. In this presentation, we'll be reviewing the Congestion Mitigation and Air Quality Improvement Program, or CMAQ, a new source of federal funds for our MPO. If you're attending our public meeting in person, you will be able to visit with submitting entities about their proposed projects and programs after this presentation. We'll also have iPads available to access our online Pick Your Proposals tool, or you can get to it on your phone by visiting www.alamoareampo.org/CMAQ. If you're watching this online, you can review the projects under Step 2 and access the Budget Game tool under Step 3 of that CMAQ webpage. Either way, we're so glad you heard about this opportunity to have your voice heard. Let's get started. The Alamo Area MPO is a public agency that conducts transportation planning and allocates federal funds to transportation projects in our 3.5 county study area. This includes Bayer, Comal, and Guadalupe counties and part of Kendall County. Over 2.1 million residents call this area home and travel 58 million miles every day on its roads and transit routes. MPOs across the country provide their regions with a forum for project selection by local officials, set policy and guide the transportation planning process, and are responsible for developing multimodal, long-range, and short-range transportation plans. Our MPO Transportation Policy Board selects projects and sets policies, and we have three advisory committees serving technical, bicycle, and pedestrian mobility advisory roles. The projects in our transportation plans are funded through several categories of federal, state, and local dollars. The MPO has discretion over three of those federal funding categories. The first, our Surface Transportation Block Grant, makes up the bulk of MPO discretionary projects and can go toward the greatest diversity of project types, from improving roadway operations to adding roadway capacity, improving public transportation, constructing facilities for bicycling and walking, and making improvements at safety hotspots. The category of transportation alternatives is dedicated to projects and programs that improve safety and mobility for people bicycling and walking. This is the first year that the MPO has had access to this third category, CMAQ. It focuses on transportation projects that generate emission reductions either directly, such as through the replacement of heavy-duty fleet vehicles, or indirectly, for instance, by upgrading traffic signal technology for better traffic flow. CMAQ stands for Congestion Mitigation and Air Quality Improvement Program. It is federal funding targeted to areas that aren't meeting national air quality standards for ozone, carbon monoxide, and/or particulate matter. While proposals that are awarded CMAQ funding have ancillary benefits, including congestion relief, safety, or other elements, it is the proposals understood emission reductions that establish eligibility for this funding source. CMAQ became a funding source for the MPO when Bayer County was designated a non-attainment area for ozone last year. Ozone is the main ingredient of smog, and levels of ozone in Bayer County had been exceeding the threshold for public health that was set in 2015 by the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency, or EPA. Bayer County was the only county in the San Antonio-New Braunfels Metropolitan Statistical Area, or MSA, to be named a non-attainment area. Only proposals within Bayer County are thus eligible for these funds. The total of CMAQ funding estimated to go to our region is $60 million over the next three fiscal years of 2020, 2021, and 2022, depending on federal funds being available. We'll stop receiving CMAQ funds following attainment of air quality standards. Funding to our area was allocated by a formula based on the population and severity of air quality exceedance. Other MPOs serving Dallas-Fort Worth, Houston, and El Paso already receive CMAQ funding targeted at reducing air pollution in those regions. The Alamo area will be receiving about 10% of the state's available CMAQ funds beginning in fiscal year 2020. Many projects and programs are eligible for CMAQ. The MPO divided the application process between projects, which are physical improvements to the roadway or transit system, and programs that would be solutions addressing air quality through behavior, training, and in other ways at large. You can see examples of eligible projects here. Note that projects that add or reduce roadway capacity were not eligible during this call for proposals. Traffic flow improvements, freight and intermodal projects, transit improvements, and bicycle and pedestrian facilities were eligible. Here you see examples of eligible programs, including those that target idle reduction, parking or transit ridership, just to name a few. To distribute these funds while maximizing air quality benefits, the MPO has developed a selection process that considers the technical score, which we'll define in more detail next, project readiness, which considers how quickly a proposal can get off the ground, the priority of the implementing aid entity, if multiple proposals have been submitted, and input from the public. There are no fixed weights to these considerations. Our committees and Transportation Policy Board will take into account all the above information as they recommend and decide on proposals to award. The technical score is a calculation of estimated emission reduction, cost effectiveness, whether an entity is offering a match over the minimum requirement, and whether a proposal has multi-agency partnerships or multimodal elements. In addition, proposals for projects were also scored on whether they addressed a corridor identified in the MPO's congestion management process as needing improvement. A multi-agency work group met twice in April to oversee the technical scoring process. The deadline to submit proposals was April 1st of 2019. We received 28 proposals in all, totaling over $166 million. Five entities submitted, including the City of Leon Valley, the City of San Antonio, UTSA, TxDOT, and Via Metropolitan Transit. Here we're taking a look at the proposals by cost. A grade separation project at Riddiman Road and a program to replace 63 vehicles in Via's fleet with CNG buses have the highest costs. Training programs for first responders submitted by both the San Antonio Police Department and TxDOT came in at the lowest level of cost, showing the diversity of proposals received. Reduction of NOx, one of the main pollutants that leads to the creation of ozone, is shown here in tons over project life. Proposals that improve intelligent transportation systems on both state and city-owned roads ranked highly, as do bus fleet replacement and traffic signal optimization. Volatile organic compounds, or VOCs, are another main pollutant that leads to ozone formation. Again, these numbers represent a reduction in tons over project life. The City of San Antonio's vehicle emissions reduction outreach campaign scored very highly for its focus on gas cap testing and replacement. Here are all submissions ranked by the technical scores. Projects that ranked highly technically also showed good emission reductions on the previous slides. Finally, here is a matrix of proposals showing the top five by category of NOx and VOC reduction and ultimate technical score. Now we're approaching the fun part by visiting www.alamoareampo.org/CMAQ. You can view details for each of the proposals. Look for View Projects under Step 2. You can review proposals by location for those that were able to be mapped. Clicking on a project will give you a pop-up box with information about that proposal and a link to the full submission form and supporting documents. Some proposals cannot be mapped because they're enacted citywide or focus on intangibles like behavior or training. You can still access information about each of these, including the full submission form and supporting documents on the next tab. When you're ready to pick your projects, choose the tab at the top of the page or return to Step 3 of our CMAQ webpage. We're accepting public input through May 10th, so make sure your voice counts. The MPO's Technical Advisory Committee, or TAC, will develop an initial funding recommendation considering those four elements mentioned before: the technical score, project readiness, priority of implementing entity, and public input. All submitted projects will be presented to the Transportation Policy Board, which will select the CMAQ-funded projects for inclusion in our transportation plans. Proposals awarded funding are expected to be selected at the June meeting of the Transportation Policy Board. Implementation of projects and programs that are selected will begin as early as October 1st of this year. This wraps up our presentation. We encourage you to review the proposals and begin our budget game. Thank you.